Let's now discuss the Manila Bay reclamation projects, which have been paused by the national government pending an impact assessment study by the Environment Department. For a reaction on this, we're now joined by one of the country's business leaders, Sergio Ortiz-Luis Jr., who is also the chairman of Waterfront Hotels and Corporation. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Stanley, and good afternoon to our listeners.
All right. We'd like to get your thoughts on moves to halt the reclamation activities in Manila Bay for a host of reasons. Are you for or against the move, and do you find the reasons valid?
Well, number one, I think there is an over-exaggeration of the numbers. No? As far as we're concerned, no. The only one that has been issued ECC and are actually working are two projects, one in Pasay and one in Manila.
Right.
The others are in the process of being issued the necessary licenses. So the problem is, you know, the president and a lot of us are going, trying to get investment abroad.
Right.
And one of the things that they have been telling us is that it's very difficult to deal with the Philippines because of our inconsistent policies. That's why they choose Vietnam or Thailand or whatever. In the case of the reclamation, to advertise that we are halting 22 or whatever is 13 projects that are ongoing is really damaging. When actually you could have said that the processing of the, you know, and there were two were halted, that should be the case. Because even the issue of inconsistent policy is one.
Okay.
But stopping projects is something that will really be terrorize possible investors. And we have a lot. Every week after each trip, investors come to Philippine Chamber of Commerce trying to get their partners or looking for from all countries. Now I think they will all disappear because of this.
Okay.
And the reason for the stoppage is, I think, quite we are told that it is inconsistent with the plan or to clean up or to preserve Manila Bay. Then, of course, if there is a reclamation, there will be dirt that will break. But at the end of the day, they are just moving the bay walk. All of this reclamation will have wider bay walk than the existing in Luneta now.
Mm-hmm.
In the same manner as in the past, when the Americans planned by Burnham reclaim and widen Rojas Boulevard.
Okay.
And after that, the bay walk was moved and the barrier was moved. And then after that, the reclamation of the CCP complex. No? And again, it moved. No? So saying that it will destroy it's a very PC. It's just saying that no reclamation is good.
Okay.
And even the issue of sunset will disappear. Of course, lalayu lang, but it will even be nearer to the sun perhaps because the baywalk and the fishermen will have their own place. Remember, this reclamation are all by LGUs, similar to BGC. Nobody is forbidden there.
Okay.
It will be improved, and the fishermen can have a better place there. And besides, the LGUs, Pasay, and in this particular case, the one affected by the whole thing, Pasay and Manila, they will give income to the cities. Like Manila, there is no more expansion area for Manila.
Uh-huh.
How much can you do with Luneta? With Escolta now? There's no, the income is limited.
Okay.
And therefore, the income can be generated, and it will be used for the social uplift of the Manileños.
Okay. Now, Mr. Ortiz-Luis, of course, they have their reasons. It is about the environment. It is about preserving the heritage of Manila Bay. And this will be taken into consideration when government makes a further study, particularly the DENR, on whether or not these reclamation activities should continue. Well, but in that regard, do you think or do you have a half step, if you will, a proposal Perhaps that both government and those businesses involved in reclamation can meet halfway?
Well, anyway, it's there already. They want to have a study. I just hope that they will not hire purely academicians, but they will include our economic managers. And see, I think there was a hearing in Congress, and Lisa Antebellos asked them to what is the economic benefit, no? I hope that will be very clear, because there will be tremendous. The land that will be reclaimed is actually owned by the city, majority.
Okay.
It's owned by the city. And it can serve as a barrier for what they call tsunamis, and no, because it can be raised, can be barrier. And it can be beautified, it will be environment friendly, done one of our runners who have worked in 40 counties, John Palapox, has said, done properly, all this reclamation in Singapore, in Japan, in Hong Kong, in the Philippines, should be a boon to the country. Because,
okay,
number one, it will give extra spaces where the city can expand, can bring new technology. Remember, the planned expansion will probably even the escalating prices of land in the area is going up and mitigating, but with the additional land that will be reclaimed, they will stabilize and
okay,
they can be more affordable, and the income generated will probably, for Manila, it will probably give them enough income to be able to give services that they cannot no longer afford because of limited income and the expansion that they need. Remember, these projects are projects of LGUs. They are not projects of the contractors. The contractors are just contractors, and they have their other partners. And I think, but what is most important,
yes,
is that the issue of they have gone to this, at least the ones that are going now, it started in 2016.
Mm-hmm.
They are
okay,
not midnight deals.
Okay.
And as a matter of fact, if I remember correctly, they were issued already, to proceed in 2021, but then they thought we need another, they put in another requirement, notice to mobilize, which is unheard of. And because I think they wanted to be very sure that the baby is consulted, the passage of the boat will not be hampered. So it was delayed again. Finally, in the case of Manila, it was issued in 2022, June.
Mm-hmm.
After how many years? How many years of hearing, public hearings, and all these things, no? All sorts of licenses. And how can they say now, after the issuing now, how can the NR say now that that's wrong?
Okay.
How can you explain that to our investors?
Okay, sir, we've of course considered the fact that these projects have been reviewed by proper agencies. In fact, they were endorsed by local governments, the cities of Manila and Pasay, you said. And we also have the Philippine Reclamation Authority, which is supposed to be on top of all of these things. Now, is that the kind of oversight that you're expecting from these agencies, for them to just say that it is illegal, it is inappropriate, the project should not have happened in the first place? What kind of message is that sending now to our investors?
Well, as I said, the billions will be lost by the two who are proceeding. And that will be heard worldwide. And how can you explain that? A license issued, which was for several years, so difficult to secure, difficult to
obtain.
Their impact assessment submitted.
Exactly.
And how can they say now that they're going to do it again? And from what I read, they will use academicians who do not have any experience in this. And they will ignore probably those who had done this in countries where they're most welcome.
Okay. Okay, sir, lastly, I'm sure you've spoken to your circles, the business circle. What is the sentiment of that group towards these developments?
Well, actually, they are saying that this is hard to explain again. If we travel now, in the present travel now with the business delegation, I'm sure the question that will be asked is, how can you do this? Mm-hmm. It's different when inconsistent policies, but this is now ongoing project approved and gotten all the necessary documents and went to the process, and they are stopped without consideration of the damages it will create to the contractors and the city.
Okay,
that would be hard to answer.
Okay, lastly, sir, what do you foresee? Would there be legal action against the government as a result of these stopping reclamation in Manila Bay?
I just don't know if that will be resorted to, because I'm sure it will be, there will be resolution here. Mm-hmm. But definitely, my estimate alone, no, for the one of Pasay, a delay in one day, just looking at how many people they're using, how many boats are there, there will be probably no less than 100 million a day.
Okay.
Losses, not even counting penalties.
Okay, surely
from
that
banks
sounds.
Or from financiers.
Okay, that sounds like a big setback.
Very easy. And in the case of Manila, there are boats there. I think there are 8 boats that are there delivering things that demurrage alone will cost, I think, about 70 million a day.
Okay. So, sir, lastly, if you want to make a call to the government, what would you want to tell them?
Well, they have to decide. If they do not trust those who have approved this, we cannot have this track record of rescinding contracts, because even this particular one, it will destroy our credibility worldwide. And for what reason? Mm-hmm. For something that it was ongoing, all of a sudden you thought of you had to do another assessment. It's unfortunate.
All right. On that note, we end this interview. Mr. Sergio Luis Ortiz Jr., business leader, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon and for your
input. Thank you so much, Stanley,
for
the opportunity.